the mighty All Blacks.
Welcome back to our fantastic voyage through the life of Elton John. For a former pub singer from Pinner, Sir Elton John's circle of friends is far wider and more blue-blooded than he could have possibly predicted.
I've met Princess Diana, I met Prince Charles, I've met Prince Andrew. Underneath that, all they like a drink, they go to the toilet, and, you know, it's all the same as that. I've always felt awkward around them, but it's gotten better over the years. They descended on Woodside once after Easter at Windsor, and they all came round for a drink at lunchtime. Queen Mother wanted a Dubonnet and lemonade, I think. I didn't have a Dubonnet, or we had the lemonade, but we had to send down the road for a Dubonnet. She was dancing with me and she was saying, I suppose you meet a lot of interesting people in your world. And I said, yes, I said, yes, Your Majesty, I'm dancing with you, for example. When we were looking in the garden, she said, you know, you have the best view of Windsor Castle in Berkshire. She said, oh, look, my daughter's in. So the flag was flown, which I thought was very funny. Oh, Princess Margaret came to one of my shows, Louder Than Concord, but not quite as pretty. She said,
do you know you are Louder Than Concord and you're not as pretty?
In February 1998, Elton John became Sir Elton John.
Sir John Elton, for services to music and charity.
Sir John Elton, receiving a knighthood from Her Queenesty the Madge.
I've read all about you Greeks.
Of all the royal family, the strongest bond Elton formed was with Diana, the Princess of Wales. There was a time
I was everything. We became friends when she was going through the divorce, when she was, you know, it was a very hard time for her. But she was very funny. She was very, you know, I mean, she always looked, she was, you know, she was full of fun and very realistic, very honest about what was going on. I was feeling like a cloud across the sun. I think in the end with Diana, she trusted the wrong people. She didn't trust the people that really she should have trusted, her true friends. There was never a continuity of friends, maybe a couple. But I always thought the people that really felt for her and really were true to her, she just was a bit airy-fairy towards the end.
We have reports from Paris that Diana, Princess of Wales, has been killed in a car accident and that her partner, Dodi Fayed, has also been killed. They were apparently being pursued by paparazzi on two motorcycles.
On a Sunday morning, David and I got up and he went to the fax machine, well, went into the office where the fax is, and there was a fax from a friend of ours saying, so sorry to hear about Diana. And we thought, what? Because we went to bed early on the Saturday night. We put the television on, and of course there was the news. That was 6 weeks after Gianni had died, and it was the most bizarre time I can ever remember.
Cortege continues on down the Mall towards Horse Guards Parade on the right, where it will leave the Mall itself.
For me, playing at the funeral of Princess Diana was probably one of the most surreal things I've ever done. You didn't show any emotion. It's not the sort of thing you do at something like this.
Now in the nave, Elton John sings Candle in the Wind with new words specially written a few days ago by Bernie Taupin.
Goodbye, England's rose. May you ever grow in our hearts. You are the grace that placed yourselves where lives were torn apart. You called out to our country and you whispered to those in pain, now you belong to heaven.
What was going through my mind is don't fuck this up. Don't sing a wrong word, don't sing a wrong note, be stoic, don't break down, and just do it to the best you can possibly do it without showing any emotion whatsoever.
Never fading with the sunset when the rain set in and your footsteps.
My heart was beating quite a lot, I have to say. I mean, this is an unreal experience, and I hope I never have to do it again.
Your legend ever will.
Can we stop? Thanks.
And that's the story of Elton John so far. It's been an amazing career, but Elton refuses to live in the past. There are still unfulfilled dreams for the future.
You tell me there's an angel in your tree.
I'd just like to maintain the level of happiness that I have now and the level of enthusiasm. Just want to remain intentionally passionate about what I do. Without passion, there is no life. And I just don't want to end up just going around the world playing your song on Rocket Man. That is not my idea of fun.
All the restless folks are
blue. Regrets, I have a few. But then again, too few to mention. I regret the people that I've hurt in my life, the pain I put people through unnecessarily because of my behavior. You can only help but just try and atone for that. She came, she saw, she conquered.
The remarkable story of Elton John. For the encore, joining him now on stage, some amazing musical guests. Tonight, Parkinson's guests include Billy Piper, Atonement star James McAvoy, and Jennifer Lopez performs live in the studio. That's Parkinson at 11:20.
Talking with Miss Marple, who is, I have discovered, a very nosy lady.
The Super Sleuth returns for a brand new series.
Would it be possible to see the body?
Madam, this is a police investigation, not an outing of the Darby and Joan.
With a star-studded list of...